Here we go. Here we go, about to start.
Washburn fans, and welcome to Yager Stadium for tonight's celebration of the 2023 Ichabod Women's Soccer NCAA National Finalists and their historic season. We're excited to honor the coaches and student athletes for their incredible achievements this season. Washburn fans, please welcome our 15th president, Dr. Julianne Mazacek.
Hello. Good evening. Thank you for being here. What a great day to be in Ichabod. Yes. I am so proud of our women's Washburn soccer program, national finalists. Very few programs ever had the opportunity to celebrate this accomplishment. It was my honor to travel in North Carolina, sit in the stands, and watch you play. You are amazing, each and every one of you. Players, coaches, trainers, staff, you achieved something incredibly special. I was most proud that you fought until the very final second. You never gave up, and you represented our university so well. And I am so proud of our fans. They were wonderful too. It is my privilege tonight to talk about your accomplishments, not only on the pitch. Your team has the most wins in program history. Yeah! But you're not only excellent on the field, you're excellent in the classroom. 18 members of this team will be recognized for the MIAA Academic Honor Roll this fall. Woo! That number is super impressive. But what is even more impressive is that it doesn't even include all the women. We would even have more. The entire Washburn campus is so happy and excited for you. You weren't here to see it, but it was such a thrill to walk through our buildings and see crowds of people gathered around TV monitors cheering you on. Most of our Ichabod family could not be in North Carolina in person to cheer you on, but please know they were in Topeka and all around the nation supporting you. Again, congratulations. And go Bods!
And now, please welcome to the stage Washburn University Athletic Director Lauren Ferrey.
Thank you. Thank you, everybody, for coming. I guess there's a delay. I didn't realize that. They say that it's about 10 to 15 degrees warmer on the turf. If that's true, you guys are freezing. It's cold. I want to take just a second. I want to see what I look like on the big screen. Isn't Dr. Mazacek awesome? It is, with her leadership, we're going to be successful for years to come. And I'm so proud to be working for her. Okay. Well, all right. If you missed that, I'll repeat it. Isn't Dr. Mazacek awesome? She is great to work with. And we're going to be successful for years to come through her leadership. Some of you know this. I grew up in Texas, so I got to say it. How about them Ichabods? This year was a spectacular year full of memories. One of the memories I have most is our win against Central Missouri here in the regionals. We waited till the very end. Davey told me we had plenty of time on the clock, but scored at the very end, put it in overtime, and then won in overtime. And that was a great win. And it showed me that this team had a long way to go before they were going to lose in this tournament. And probably would. I didn't think they were going to lose, but at the end, we didn't come out on top. I do want to tell you one thing. I've followed our soccer team since we started. I love coming to the games. I miss very few home games. And I have to tell you, I don't really understand all the rules in soccer. So for most games, I stand on the east side of the stadium. And I do that so I can hear Coach Phillips. He has a big voice, and I can hear him. And so when he yells at the officials, I yell at the officials. I think I'm doing the right thing. Well, this year we're playing, and he's not yelling very much. And I go, well, this is really strange because I'm seeing some plays I don't really think are the right calls. So after one of the games, I asked Coach Phillips, I said, why aren't you yelling like before? Are the officials that much better this year? And he said, no, I'm trying to be good. I'm trying not to yell at the officials. I said, well, that doesn't work for my system. So then I changed my system to where I start yelling at all the calls against Washburn. I figured I missed some, but I was going to be right more times than not. Now for what I was brought up here to do, 6 years ago, I hired Coach Phillips, made a good decision to bring him in to lead the program, and he has done a tremendous job. I think better days are coming. So with that, it is my, I'm very proud to introduce the 2023 MIAA head coach of the MIAA champions, the head coach 2023 NCAA regional champions, the head coach of the NCAA national finalists, Coach Davey Phillips.
Thank you for coming. I'm excited because we have a lot of internal dialogue, but I don't get the chance to publicly thank the team and everyone else that's been involved to make this season a really special run. These ladies have been committed to a journey of maximizing their potential since day one. And this year they've been unbelievable in their effort, their growth, their achievement. And for that, I can't say thank you enough. So ladies, thank you. Give them one more applause, please. And like Dr. Mazacek said, they're unbelievable students in the classroom too. They are engaged in their education and they're leaders in their community. So I hold all the ladies up here to the highest esteem. It's an unbelievable privilege to lead them. I also want to thank a couple other people here. Lauren, our athletic trainer, she was unbelievable this year. It's really, really hard to go August to December with a healthy team, and we picked up some injuries, but nothing major, and Lauren is a big part of that, so thank you, Lauren. Maria, our strength and conditioning coach, is unbelievable as well. We are so lucky to have such a terrific support system, and she is first class in what she does. Kyle, our SID, has been unbelievable in telling the story this year, so thank you, Kyle. Ron, our equipment manager, makes sure we are suited and booted and have everything we need to go and really perform. He's a legend here on campus, so yeah, give it up for Ron. We have unbelievable administration from the university level to the athletic department, and we owe them a great amount of gratitude, so thank you both very much. Appreciate what you guys do for the young women up here. And then our fans are unbelievable. We have the best fans in the conference, if you ask me. They travel the road games. We have parents. We have passionate alumni. And we have a loud student body. And I said it a couple times, a couple games during our run. I think you guys willed us on. And so we are so appreciative of the support and everything you guys do to make Washburn such a special place to be a student athlete, to be a coach, to be a student. It really is a first-class institution. We are grateful to be a part of it, and thank you again for everyone who makes it such an incredible institution. Go Bods.
All right, fans, it's now time to hear from some of the players from on the field. Please welcome junior midfielder Chloe Quintana.
Hi, guys. First of all, I just wanted to say thank you guys so much for coming out here tonight and for all the support you guys have shown us throughout this season. This team has been so special to be a part of because we've shown up each and every day with a lot of intent to grow individually and grow as a team. We knew from the beginning that we were capable of making it to the national championship, and it felt so rewarding to see all of that hard work and commitment pay out. And although the odds didn't go completely in our favor, we had a lot of fun and success, and I am so extremely proud of everything that this team's accomplished. I love this team so much, and I'm so excited to see what the next season has in store for us.
And now, welcome to the stage, your MIAA Defensive Player of the Year and First Team All-American, Jordan Tempest.
Hi, everybody. Thank you guys for coming out today. Thank you guys for supporting us throughout the entire season. It was a really fun one. I mean, it was very exciting throughout the entirety of it. And I just want to thank our professors especially for working with us these past 2 to 3 weeks, because it's been a little stressful. But, just a huge shout out to the girls. Love you guys so much. You guys have been great teammates, especially as a transfer. It wasn't easy coming in, but you guys made it a lot easier. So thank you guys. Thank you to the staff, trainers, weight room coaches, Maria, Lori. You guys are the best, and we couldn't have done it without any of you guys. Thank you.
And now, welcome to the stage, your MIAA Goalkeeper of the Year, Reagan Wells.
Hi, everyone. On behalf of the team, we want to thank everyone for coming out tonight and those who have supported us throughout the season. I could not have asked for a better way to end my career. Going to the national tournament was an unforgettable experience, and I'm so thankful for my time and memories made at Washburn. Thank you.
And now we would like to recognize each student athlete on the Washburn soccer team NCAA national finalists. First up, senior goalkeeper, number 0, Reagan Wells. Freshman goalkeeper, number 00, Haley Beck. Junior goalkeeper, number 1, Allie Harrington. Freshman defender, number 2, Lindsay Mall. Junior defender, number 3, Taylor Bachover. Freshman midfielder, number 4, Presley Amick. Senior forward, number 5, Riley Painter. Sophomore midfielder, number 6, Hunter McWilliams. Junior defender, number 7, Josie Boyle. Junior midfielder, number eight, Jaden Allen. Sophomore forward, number nine, Aubrey Tangsley. Junior midfielder, number 10, Anna Maruzabal. Junior forward, number 11, Chloe Shuckman. Sophomore midfielder, number 12, Belle Kennedy. Freshman midfielder, number 13, Grace Peterson. Sophomore defender, number 14, Lakin Rold. Junior midfielder, number 15, Vivi Soto Herrera. Junior midfielder, number 16, Chloe Quintana. Sophomore defender, number 17, Sydney Achilles. Junior forward, number 18, Riley Wells. Freshman forward, number 19, Kylie Henricks. Junior midfielder, number 20, Katie Cammies. Sophomore defender, number 21, Shandon Carr. Sophomore defender, number 22, London Furnish. Sophomore defender, number 23, Brooke Powell. Freshman forward, number 24, McKinley Roan. Freshman defender, number 25, Rylan Snyder. Freshman defender, number 26, Kate Whittler. Junior defender, number 27, Jordan Tempest. Assistant coach, Jess Hillibert. And your head coach of the national runner-up, Washburn Ichabod's head coach, Davey Phillips. Let's hear it for the members of the 2023 Washburn Ichabod soccer team.
Washburn soccer has rewritten the history books in 2023. They could do more of that starting on Thursday.
Washburn. credit to Wichita. Incredible game. Good team. The crowd was fantastic tonight. You know, there's so much energy. We're hoping for another big turnout to help us. It's such a good feeling to play in front of family and friends at home, Yager Stadium. We talk about making a fortress every time out, and knowing that we have terrific support behind us, pushing us on. Might have been the difference tonight, right? So we're excited for more fans to come out on Sunday and continue to push us on.
Program record, 9 players earn all MIAA honors, along with head coach Davey Phillips earning MIAA Coach of the Year. Reagan Wells was named the MIAA Goalkeeper of the Year. Jordan Tempest took home Defensive Player of the Year honors. And McKinley Roan was selected co-freshman of the year in the MIAA. 5 Ichabods earned all MIAA honors. Reagan Wells, Jordan Tempest, Chloe Shuckman, and Belle Kennedy. Roan and Vivi Soto Herrera were members of the second team, while Taylor Bachover was third team selection. Josie Boyle and Anna Maruzabal were named all MIAA honorable mention. 3 Ichabods were selected to the D2 CCA All-Central Region teams, with Jordan Tempest landing on the first team and Chloe Shuckman and Reagan Wells earning second team honors. Tempest was also named a D2 CCA First Team All-American selection. Head coach Davey Phillips and assistant Jessica Hillebert were named the Central Region Staff of the Year by the United Soccer Coaches. The United Soccer Coaches also selected 4 Ichabods for the All-Central Region teams, with Chloe Shuckman and Jordan Tempest earning first-team honors, and Reagan Wells and Belle Kennedy being named to the second team. Both Tempest and Shuckman were later named All-Americans by the USC. The Ichabod's historic season also included the record for most wins in a season. Highest national ranking at number 6. Regular season MIAA champions, Central Regional champions, and national finalists. At this time, we would like to present our Ichabods with their first ever Central Regional Championship Trophy, which they earned on December the 1st after a 2-1 victory over Emporia State in Ashland, Ohio. Give it up for your 2023 Central Regional Champions! Fans, please help me one last time in honoring your 2023 Ichabod Women's Soccer Team. Please join us on the concourse for an autograph and picture opportunity. Thank you for attending tonight, and go Bobs!